Greetings, guys and gals, and welcome back to Let's Play King's Quest IV, The Perils of Rosella. Uh-oh. Oh, I thought that was the troll there for a second. We last time got the magic fruit that we need to save our father, King Graham, but we now must go back through this cave, which is not going to be a very fun ordeal. So yeah, and we're also going to be taking a big step in getting the, Unicorn, which is the first of the three tasks the Mean Witch Lalotte made us do. So let's do that. Place a board over the chasm. There we go. And she'll pick it up along the way, which is always good. I like how you get points for that, by the way. That's kind of fun. Save. We already have 65 points. That's a decent start, I'd say. Oh. No grr, so that means we're going to save. And I believe we must go north. I can't actually remember. And actually, no, I think it's to the west. This cave is so darn annoying. The lantern, by the way, it doesn't really help to show you where you're, like, the cave itself, but it does help you actually see Rosella. Oh no, grr! We're gonna restore. Once the troll shows up, escape is pretty much, not an option. So, as soon as you hear grr, that's your, cue to restore. So yeah. No grr, so that means we should be able to get out of here safely, I hope. And, yeah. Nothing super exciting going on at the beginning, but, you know, we're just getting back out of the cave that we went in last time, so... Where's the exit? Is it this way? I can't remember now. Is it the bottom? I thought it was up. I could have sworn it was. Let's just keep going up from here. Getting into the cave is one thing, but then you have to get out. And, No, apparently it's not this way. Odd. We have to go this way. No? Oh, here we go. This may be more difficult than I thought. I might cut out some of this if I just stumble in the cave too much. Where the heck? I thought this is where the exit was, but maybe I'm mistaken. Oh, there it is. Pfft. Derp. That's where I thought I went before, but apparently it didn't register. Anyway, oh, we also got a bone from the cave entrance, which is good. And now that we are out of the cave, let's extinguish the oil lantern again. I don't think we're actually going to need to use it again, but hey, we should probably just save the oil anyway. And we'll wear the crown so we can get back out. You don't need to. Are you sure about that? Oh, can I just swim out? You are swept out by the waterfall. Oh, well, apparently you can just go out that way. I thought it would kill me. I guess not. So, now where to? We have the fruit, which means that once we... Oh, by the way, you can actually be a really big jerk and do this. Save the game before I do this. You can actually eat the fruit yourself. Oh, not the fruit. The fruit. Before you know it, you've eaten the whole thing. A feeling of vitality courses through your body, and it deducts 10 points from your score because you just basically killed your father by doing that. Yeah, not exactly a kind of a jerk move there, Rosella, but thankfully I saved so I can undo it. Actually, we should be careful around here because there is a hostile being around here, so we want to be careful. Now, this next part of the game is one of the other main parts this game is criticized for, and you'll see why when we get there. It is probably one of the most annoying puzzles, well, definitely the most annoying puzzle in this game, but one of the more annoying and infamous parts of the King's Quest series. More infamous than the, actually, would it be more infamous than the bridge in 2? I'm not sure, but it's infamous regardless. So let's head on over to the pier, because what we're actually going to do now is we're going to go to the, we're going to go to Genesta's Island, which is relatively close to where we started. Like, this is the screen we started on, if I remember correctly. So, but we want to go on the pier so we can get a little bit extra distance. Because obviously, Rosella can't swim forever. We don't have, like, a freaking silver scale or anything like that. But, yeah, we're going to have to go on the pier to get some extra distance first. And we're going to have to be careful, too, because there are some dangerous things in the water. So we'll save once more. Perils of Rosella. Now, let me just double check to make sure we have everything we need for this part, because this part's probably one of the harder parts of the game. So let's go! swim to freedom! Or to Genesta's island, whatever. You can find sharks and a whale in the sea. Oh, there's the whale. Yeah. We don't want to deal with him just yet. Uh-oh. Oh, shoot, did we just get sucked in? We did. Horrors, you've been swallowed by a huge whale, and now your game is unwinnable. Yeah. Yes, it is. So we gotta do that again. That's what I said about being careful in the water. It's not exactly the most wonderful thing to do. But yeah. Hopefully that whale won't show up again. Shark! Hey, that's the same music from the previous game. Jeez, this is not a very forgiving sea. You made a tasty morsel for that hungry shark. Just rubbing it in now, aren't you? Oh, well, let's try again. Yeah. That's funny. I didn't think this would be a big annoyance, but apparently it is. Hopefully we'll be able to get to the other side before the whale or shark shows up. But yeah, you actually do need to get captured by the whale, but we don't we don't have the item that we need to escape it yet. Hey, there's a peacock. Whew, we've made it to Genesta's island. And there's actually only one thing we need to do here right now. So we need to find that peacock again, because the peacock will give us a useful item. Actually, up here is Genesta's castle, which we can explore for a while if we want to. But Genesta's tiny fairies guard the palace door. Let's go inside. Open door. Bleep. Oh, the sound effects. And let's see, we have quite a few different ways we can go. I think all these are locked, though. You can't, the door's locked, yeah. I'm pretty sure this way is locked, too, at this point. Yep, I believe the only place we can actually go is left. We can actually see Genesta, but she is resting right now, which means that we won't be able to do anything with her. Actually, I believe you don't actually have to go to the castle until the very end of the game, but we may as well just explore it for the fun. For the fun. For the funs. And by the way, I like the fact that she actually has railings on her staircases. There's another YouTuber who I saw play this game who goes by the name Dylandow3000, and he said, "You know, Genesta is one of the good guys because she actually has railings on the staircases." And I got a kick out of that. Let's look at Genesta. The lovely fairy is visibly fading fast. Within hours, if she doesn't get back her magic talisman, jeez, she'll be dead. This will be a tragic loss for Tamir, as the evil Allot will come to power. Yeah, so we need to get in gear here and get in gear and save Genesta before it is too late. Oh, what's going on? Oh, there we go. Yeah, apparently the stairs are a little more of a hassle in this game, so... Yeah. Thankfully, in Genesta's palace, we won't have to worry about it too much because of the railings, but yeah. Anyway, let's go back outside to the island and see if we can find that peacock again. Because he will give us something rather useful. Yes, we are aware that there are fairies around the door. Yeah, I like this island. It's kind of a fun little area. Like, very ornate with the swans and everything. I mean, look at all that. That's wonderful. What's the bird in the tree doing? Look, bird. There are many exotic birds on this island. Yeah, I can see that. Oh well. Let's explore some more. I like the little... Oh, I should have crossed the swan bridge, but I didn't. There's the peacock again. We're gonna follow him. Man, oh, this is taking longer than I thought, just getting to that freaking peacock. Let's see, here he is. Is he gonna do it? He eventually will drop a feather that we're gonna need to pick up. Ooh, very pretty. And there he goes some more. Nope, he's like, hey, you see these feathers? You can't have them, but you can see them, yeah. Look, don't touch, as they say. Oh, well. Yeah, my grandfather, he had a, he actually restored a Model A Ford, which I believe, Model A, yeah. Which was not the first one. Actually, Model T was the first, if I remember correctly. But anyway, he spent many years of his life... is that it there? Hopefully it is. Yeah, it is! I guess that happened earlier and I just didn't see it. Let's see, we now have the peacock feather. Excellent, so we can go to the whale now. But anyway, he restored a Model A Ford. And he took us for rides in it and everything. And he put a sticker on it that said, look, don't touch. Because he actually... Oh, great, not the shark again. He would actually... Yeah, he would actually like use that as his main car. So like when he would go grocery shopping or something, he'd park it and he'd put that sticker on it because he'd be like, yeah, you can look at it, but you can't touch it because, you know, I spent freaking 20 years making it. So yeah, anyway, where's that whale? Should be close by, I hope. Otherwise, we're just going to swim for forever. Oh, we made it back here, actually. Okay, let's catch some air first and then go back. I want us to find that whale. I didn't know you could actually make it all the way there. That's interesting. Anyway, there he is. Oh, in we go. Horrors, you've been swallowed by a huge whale. And we're going to save here because this part is annoying. Actually, I might just use the cave save. The cave save. I love it. I like it. Because we're not going to need it anyway. There is a bottle floating here. I think let's try and get it. Can I get the bottle? You're not close. Oh, it's moving around. Okay, that's why. Okay. Let's stand so we don't drown. Can we read what's in the bottle? Or maybe we should just look at the bottle. Look. Bottle. It appears to be an old glass wine bottle. It seems that there is a note in the bottle. Can we open the bottle? You don't need to open it. Oh, well. Just read the note then, perhaps. You don't have it. Gotta be so freaking specific, don't you? Get note. There we go. Now can I read the note? Not read the note. It's black and white and red all over. Drug dealers are terrorizing the city of Lytton. You need a partner to help put away these bad guys in Police Quest 1. Of course, Sierra, advertising one of their other games. Can we look at the skeleton? The skeleton of an unlucky man rests atop the wreckage of a small boat. Oh, what a shame. Now, this is the part I was talking about that's really annoying. You have to climb the tongue of this whale. And this is one of the most annoying parts in King's Quest history because it is so specific. You have to be like, it's like brain surgery, I tell you. Like, as you can see, I'm not having very good luck with it. So I'm going to slow down my game. Go slow mode. Oh, great. Now it means I'm going to take even longer to get up. Okay. Okay. No! Oh, great. Okay, let's try over here. Nope, no luck. This is the part that's going to take me ages, and I may cut this out a little bit because it is very specific. So, yeah. Oh! No luck there. How about over here? Oh! Nothing there. Over a little bit this way, maybe? Nope. How about over here? Ah! You know what? I think we'll climb the whale tongue next time on Let's Play King's Quest 4 because it's going to take a long time to do. So I'll see you then.